Hey, you, shut your beak. They say they can tell your religion by the shape of the back of your neck. They say that it's all in the eyes and the mouth as to whether you're Mickey or Jack. I recently moved to a neighborhood. They stare at me morning and night. They don't know what foot I kick with. They don't know if I'm left or right. The wrong foot, the wrong foot. They don't know what foot I kick with. They don't know if I'm left or right.
This is our wee parlour. And no matter what happens in this street, of course, we hear about was an old doll called O'Candriac. She lives near Faith. Now, you've seen O'Candriac all Saturday nights, but no matter what happens, she comes in to tell my mammy about it. Well, she was out charring. She says she wasn't charring, she was housekeeping. If you ask me, she was scrubbing. That's what she was doing. For this old doll in one of the better class districts in Belfast, past the night in me stage, like, so you may guess, like, what she is. Which had never a good word to say about this woman she worked for. She came in and said she was an old cat and she wouldn't give you this and she wouldn't give her a dinner. She said, what do you work for the woman for if you don't like her? Never answered me. My mammy said the same. She said, don't take the woman's money and ridicule her, she says. Well, I believe things come to a head a Tuesday. It was Tuesday night. She come ramming in here and you think my mammy made it. Then the way she started, she relived the thing all over again. It appears she turned on this woman. Without O'Condriac, something snapped. Like, you get to that stage, something snapped. She turned on the lady what she worked for, and I believe from her description, dogs wouldn't lick the woman's blood.
Listen, you.
Pardon?
Did you take any bread when I was out?
I never touched no bread.
Well, it's very strange. There were 7 slices in the kitchen when I went out, and now there's only 6.
A slice of bread might have reared you, but heavens, it never reared me.
How dare you?
This is a hungry hole.
Oh, well, then you must have stole it.
Nobody will accuse me in, Yuggin. Away to hell.
I am going to phone my husband.
Your husband? Ha! That wee wart. What could he do? Never seen a hungry hole like it. One sardine in the house, by heavens, you tell everybody you'd fish for your dinner.
How dare you? How dare you? Get out. Get out!
Wasn't it a gag all the same? Wasn't it a gag? So she says the woman accused her of knocking, and like according to her, she would knock now. However, she wasn't long out of work. Like, for belief, she's a right worker. Like, she is a right worker. She was in, and she wasn't housekeep no more. Oh, she's in education now, a cleaner in a school. I know she'd got the job in the school because I heard her telling the woman next door all about it. Hello, didn't know if you'd be up yet or not. Do you mean that old cat I worked for at Castlereagh? Walked out on her. Walked out. Well, she was sorry, she got nobody like me. I've got a start, I wasn't long out. I've got a job in a school with the Education Authority. Start not too bad in the morning and finished early.
You're not like me, Lily. I work at night.
Lovely gentleman, the headmaster was lovely, spoken all. Like, I'm not cleaning or nothing, I'm doing like floors, like for wages, and nearly double the money she was giving me. He's a lovely gentleman, he spoke beautiful. We, says, would love, he says, to have you with us. Well, I says, if any time you're stuck, I says, or short of a teacher, that I says, don't be afraid to ask, I says, if you're short of a teacher, I will just wire in, isn't it great? So here, dear, I was just saying to my mammy, I had a wee cup of tea the other night. She says, that's wonderful. It says the people is connected with education. Like, for my mammy's well up, she's well read. My mammy asked my mammy when any queen was crowned or who married who or who died. You can rhyme them all off and who left who and all that. So there is a lot of people connected with education, like, when you think of it. Like, for Mrs. O'Candriac, it's maybe scrubbing the school out till the very highest professor in the Queen's University. And I come in the other night and says, hello, mammy. She says, shush, my mammy. She says, shush. I wouldn't disturb her, for she's fascinated with the television. Of course, the BBC, naturally. Channels 1 and Channels 2. My mummy has her 2 channels, and she marks her radio times and all. Well, there was this discussion on education. Of course, you don't speak when she's listening, for she digests it all. And they were discussing this thing on the television, and my mummy and me was fascinated.
Good evening. River Rammer has from time to time had many interesting discussions. I think tonight tops them all. Tonight we're going to skirt around Skid By and generally discuss the question of education. Now, education has come under fire recently from many quarters, and as a result of that, we brought a panel into the studio, a very distinguished panel indeed, and I'm very glad to welcome to the studio someone whose face and voice indeed is very familiar to you all. It's Mr. Billy Hulk. He is chairman for the propagation of non-labour. Good evening. We also have Mrs. Mary O'Reilly, and very, very highly distinguished indeed. She is at present president of the Theatrical Catholic France Society. We also have Mr. Hiram Diefenheffer coming to us on exchange to Northern Ireland from one of the most distinguished universities from America. And, of course, well known in all circles, indeed, for her part in demonstrations. She's always at the front, as you have seen in any television clip of news that we have seen, is that staunch woman of faith and loyalty. Mrs. Lily Banner, she's the chairman of the Sandy Row Protestant Defense Culture Association.
Good evening.
Mr. Hulk, you're a very knowledgeable man on many subjects. Indeed, you have figured heavily in many to dispute. Have you something to offer here? What is your views exactly on education?
Well, as regards my opinion, I would say that the educational system in this particular country is definitely defective. There is no doubt about it. I mean, I speak as an ordinary common 5'8", and I'm not ashamed of that. Tonight we are surrounded by so-called intellectuals, and the theatrical people and all them personal rubbish. Well, I would say, like, I am not highly versed in theatre. We have Mrs. O'Reilly here tonight, and she has a theatre. Well, I have never been to your theatre, only once. On it's an occasion I never forget, because it was in her theatre here that I met the wife. I couldn't very well afford her, like, because we were the only two in the audience. I work for the firm of Harry Smith Textile Company. I'm not allowed to mention the name of the owner on this particular program by being BBC. Every time I went to see the gentleman what owns the factory, I was told that there was a deficiency of £200,000 a year. That was written down every year as a loss for the last 15 years. Well, I must say now that there's something wrong with that man's education, because I would like to know how he is losing £200,000 a year and is able still to buy 7 Rolls Royces every year for the chairman and his board of directors. I mean, there's something wrong. There's something definitely wrong.
It would appear that money is education and education is money, so there's a tie here somewhere. Mrs. O'Reilly, associated as you are with the theatre, do you think there's a possible link between the theatre and education, or education and the theatre?
Personally, I had a very good education. I was taught in the convent by the blessed nuns in Mullingar, a marvellous reverend mother. All I know, she taught me in Gaelic. I think it's a pagan language we have in the north. Every child should be taught to speak Gaelic, and no English should be used at all.
Listen, you. If they teach them nothing but Gaelic in schools and no English at all, sure their fathers and their mothers wouldn't know one bloody word the child was saying.
And wouldn't that be the blessed day for Ireland?
If Mrs. O'Reilly thinks it's so bloody good in Mullingar, let her go back there. What the hell's she doing up here? Away back to Mullingar among the rest of the heifers. Talking about education, I'm in front of the educational system in Northern Ireland at the present time. They forgot that Ulster is British. I had a wee niece of my own in the other night, a couple of drinks, a bit of a cotton jollification. There's no harm in that these days. You get little pleasure anywhere, I'm telling you. And we're having a wee bit of a tune and all that, and the child was asked up to sing the sash. One wee girl from Cack Ferguson, she didn't know a word of the sash my father wore. I was up front to give me a red face in front of my women in the lodge, so she did. And the daddy had to take her into the scullery and teach it, tell her. Is that what this country's coming to? That no child knows pro party tunes, no child knows nothing, and soon we'll be in the common market, so we will. And the Italians will be coming over and singing God knows what, the language that nobody understands. Forget about your reading and your writing, your arithmetic. Teach the children of the bar the Protestant songs. For God help Mr. Paisley when he comes back from America and strikes up the sash, or the Protestant boys not one child in his audience or his congregation know a bloody word he's singing still not.
No wonder they have to write what they mean on gable walls of the like of you about.
Mr. Diefenheffer, you're probably better qualified to comment here than anyone else as an outsider coming, as it were, from the United States of America. What is your personal opinion of our educational system here?
Well, I don't think about it at all. Never, ever.
Oh, what subject exactly are you studying at Queen's University?
I'm studying sums. arithmetic, you know, lolly, money.
And then what would you do in the event of your not getting your degree? If you fail in all subjects, what really would you take up, as it were?
Well, if I don't ever get a degree and I come out without any qualifications at all, I'll just take advantage of the situation here, and if I'm just called stupid, I'll go straight into politics.
The previous speaker had very little to say. He's a man of few words, but then, of course, he's a sensible American. And wasn't it the Irish that founded that beautiful country? He believes in our own slogan, silence is gold.
Determined, please.
I come here to mouth. You're trying to shut him down for too long. No wonder they have to rain for the
I don't believe that the politics you have brought them.
Silence is golden. Well, it's a Gaelic.
Don't have a right. Why? I speak for the people. I speak for the
people.
Now, time is running out. Summing up quickly, it seems that education is a marvellous thing. We are all agreed, and I am personally delighted that I had a very good education and am a person of culture, but nevertheless, that doesn't excuse the fact that the clack has beaten us. So from all of us here, in a nutshell, it seems to be, whether it's do, re, mi, or ABC, the main thing is to teach. Until this time next week, good night.
Excuse me, now, you're leaving the Labour Exchange. That means you're obviously unemployed.
I am indeed, thank God.
And what have you been in doing today?
I have been in getting a few shillings.
This is what? National
this is a lovely country.
Really?
Well, I have several things, you see. I have the unemployment benefit, thanks be to God. And I have the medical allowance, and I have the family allowance, and I have the social security. Tis a grand country altogether. It's a lovely morning.
But you don't sound to me as if you're from Northern Ireland.
Oh, I'm not. More's the pity. I have always regretted that sort of thing, do you see? I've always regretted that. I'm not. I'm from the South.
Well, do you just come up and collect the money every Friday?
I do. There's a decent man runs me in a taxi every Friday, and I come up, and I get me a few shillings, and I go back again, do you know?
But that surely isn't allowed.
It's not allowed. Oh, yes, there's a lot allowed. As I was saying, I have the family allowance, and that's allowed, and all the allowances are allowed. It's very good.
No, what I mean is...
It's a great country.
No, if you're not a native of this country, you
Oh, I am. I'm Irish. We're all Irish. Well, it's hard to find employment in my line, you see. I'm a sweeper up after coronations, you see, and I haven't worked since Her Glorious Majesty was last crowned, you know. But I come along. I was anxious to work. I would like to work, but it's hard in these times, you know.
Well, have you tried getting a job?
Oh, many times I have tried. I have been in below. I was talking to a gentleman, a nice civil man he is, thanks be to God. And he added up, you see, what I was getting. Well, I have 18 children, do you know? And I have a wife, she's ill, and she's seldom out of bed, as you can well understand. And they added up the allowance for that, you see, and the rent allowance, and the extra assistance I would get in my travelling allowance. And the only job that would be comparable to the money I was getting in below, do you see, from the nice gentleman, would be Chancellor of the Exchequer. And I thought about the position of the Chancellor of the Exchequer, but to tell you the truth, I didn't fancy it. It would mean me getting out of bed in the morning, and I try to avoid that. You're a decent man, as nice to speak to you, as friendly to speak to you.
Excuse me, can I ask you if you're employed at the moment?
At this moment of time,
yes.
No.
What do you do normally?
Well, I'm an engineer in factory.
Yes. And what do you do there?
My position is, I suppose you call me a strike starter.
A strike starter?
Yes.
What is a strike starter?
A man who starts strikes. I'll tell you what our dispute is at the present time. This has been off and on. I mean, this isn't the first time we've been out, and it certainly won't be the last. I went to management on behalf of a deputation. There was no utensil supplied for our tea break, and I put in an application. Well, right enough, the matters in that respect, they were very good in that respect, but the things arrived, and I thought they were very curious, to tell you the truth, like, because I'm not used, I'm a refined person. I mean, they sent big, ugly, bloody, thick things, I mean, you know, this morning. When I went to get them, like, there was no satyrs with them, there was nowhere to rest their peace. So, of course, the man detailed me, and I went up to see the management, and I said, these cups are too thick, and he turns around and he says, we don't give satyrs, he says, to mugs. Well, like, I take exception to that remark, I'm no mug.
Well, are you going to arbitrate?
Pardon?
Are you going to arbitrate?
Well, no, I went before my breakfast this morning. I'm out now. Everything's going to a standstill. The men's all out. Exports now has stopped. Now I have no idea when the factory will be starting again. There's the 187 people all coming down now to sign on. We're out. I mean, we have cause for grievance. This isn't the first time it's happened. It won't be the last. But what I'm going to do now, I'm going to the Waste and Measure Department, and I'm going to ask the gentleman there. I mean, they're very civil people. You speak to them, right? I'm going around there to ask the definition, like, between a cup and a mug. And mind you, if there's that much difference, and I'm no mug, they'll never be back, never. Not the last time, not the last time.
Excuse me. Well, there's no point in asking you if you're employed. You're obviously in the UDA or the IRA.
No, no.
Well, what are you in?
NH.
NH?
National Health. I'm coming from the dentist. I just had a tooth took out.
Oh. Can I ask you, are you concerned about the labour problem?
I think I am indeed. Nobody more so, sir.
Well, is your husband fully employed?
Oh, you can say that again. You can say that again.
So you're both fully conversant then with the labour problem?
Oh, we are. Oh, nobody more so. Tell me nothing about labour. Tell you the truth, I could teach you a thing or two.
They're all got me on again. I was just thinking there when I was washing the dish. You know what I was thinking? I think there's a certain amount of discontent, like, at the turn of the year. It's not like my mammy, like, is discontented. Like, when Christmas is over and all, she says, oh, the spring cleaning will have to be done. She'll have me over the knees, painting this and papering the hour. No, it's not my mammy's discontent, but, like, I have sensed it in the street. Take Emily Beattie. Well, anybody can take her, like, we'll want her. But take Emily Beattie, like, I think the rat has set in. I happened to meet her on the street the other day, and I just says, hello, Emily.
Hello, Emily.
Hello.
I'm just thinking there, I was round for a wee toady wee chaps you would hardly see. I had 3 pence change out of 10 shillings. Isn't it desperate? I'm near scared to go in to tell my mammy the price of meat's wicked.
Oh, it's shocking, shocking. Do you know something? I hate this street. I wish we could get out of it.
What's wrong? The street's beautiful.
It's not half good enough for my Willie and me.
Well, listen, if it's good enough for my mammy and me, it's certainly good enough for Willie and you.
Oh, well, if we could get another place, we'd be away tomorrow.
Emily, I tell you something. The time you've carried back everything in this neighbourhood that you have buried, you're not a flitted for 5 years. That's what I said straight to her face when I came in too double. I told my mummy what I had said. She said you did not say I did. Well, my mummy had a laugh, although she wouldn't let you see her. So here she kept at it the whole week. And then I was kicking out the parlour window, and didn't I see a great confab going on between Emily Beattie and Earl Orange Lily and Mrs. O'Candria? And a woman was telling me at the top of the street there's 2 or 3 families of fiends has got in.
Well, apart from all that, Lily, I'd love to get out of this street. Sure, old houses are falling down round you.
Oh, come, it'd be an awful break. Sure, you've been here since you were married 23 years.
Ach, I know. But sure, it's not a bit convenient anyway. For my Willie's baroo's been changed. It's an awful old trail for him every Thursday.
Pretty often. Anyway, where would you go? Go down to the housing trust. Tell them you're a fiend and they'll fix you up tomorrow. I wouldn't do that. They might put her in unity flaps.
I wouldn't like that at all.
Listen, I tell you what, tell me you're intimidated.
Couldn't do that, sure, it would worry the life out of me, will I?
Ach, just slightly intimidated. Go down to the lady in the house and have you 2 breaks up your yard. There's the wee rent man, why don't you ask him? I'll run on, I don't have to see him. I'm paid up to the end of the month. Hi, wee fella, come here, I want you. The wee rent fella's your mark, you know, for he would know the ropes. Howie lad, Emily Beattie here's just saying she's sick of the street. Could you get her another house or an exchange or that?
Well, now I'm leaving the man that owns these houses. I'm starting in the housing executive on Monday.
Like the housing trust?
Uh-huh.
Ach, you're landed. He's starting working for the housing trust. Well, give one to her.
Well, now, it wouldn't depend entirely on me. She would have to go through the normal channels.
Oh, is there channels you go through? Ach, and she has no television. Well, maybe you would speak like knowing her. Would you speak? He would speak for you. You'd speak.
Well, now, it wouldn't depend entirely on me, I'm warning you.
Well, listen, when do you start on Monday?
Uh-huh.
All right then, I'll take her down on Monday.
Ah, well, all right, I'll see you on Monday then.
You're landed. Well, she talked about the wee street and nothing was good enough and this wasn't good enough. I was all cut for sure, like, unfairing about the neighbours weren't good enough. Discontentment sets in, you couldn't stop somebody to get a notion in their head. So Monday morning come and I seen Earl O'Condriac and Emily leaving the street. And of course, I knowed rightly where they were going. I don't know what you're on to look for another house for, Emily, for this wee district is very heartsome. Come on. Just you go into the city hall and tell the man what you require. There's Queen Victoria, Emily. She has seen it all.
Listen, away into the city hall and find out what room the housing is, for perhaps it's like a rabbit warren in there. I'll wait on ye. Don't like the look of you, you dirty looking British. Wish to heavens Emily hadn't left me on my own. This is Haven with sex mechanics. Emily, well, did you find out?
It's not there at all, it's in College Square.
Where the hell's College Square?
Don't know, but look, I'll ask that woman over there. Excuse me.
Oh, yes.
Wonder, could you tell me where College Square is, please?
College Square in Belfast. I'm sorry, I'm just off for the day in Belfast. I come from the south myself. I had to come off to do a few messages for the girls, if you understand me. I thought when we went into the common market you might be able to buy them either side of the border, but it appears not. I have to get them in Belfast and smuggle them back, if you understand me. Now, College Square, is there a college in this village of Belfast?
Certainly there's colleges, dozens of them.
It's Dublin now, I could tell you in a flash, College Green near Trinity and all that, you know. College Square, to be near a college. If I was you, I'd walk straight up there and show you can't miss it. That's what they always say. Bannock, lad.
Well, did you find out?
She doesn't know. She's a free state foreigner.
And we can do nothing right. Look, I'll ask that wee man there. Excuse me, could you tell me where it is, College Square?
College Square. Yes, I am telling you, if you are making to listen, you are crossing straight over the road and past the corner that I am owning. Then up Billington Place, you are passing the three banks. Then you are coming to a shop with two fronts in it that is owned by my son. College Square, yes, you will find it is beside the College of the Technologies. Shalom. Come on, it's a way round near the tech. Come on.